So basically, I'm going to talk about Bitcoin. Everyone says Bitcoin Cash, but there's one Bitcoin, and it is Bitcoin Cash. It's the same one without sync shit or anything like that added. And I'll tell you another thing that no one seems to get. There is no such thing as this new blockchain thing. There is Bitcoin. Blockchain was invented in 1979. It's a Lamport signature. The innovation is economic. Full stop. It didn't work in 1979. It didn't work in reiteration in 1983 because it didn't have economics.
I created Bitcoin to ensure that there was a system that you couldn't get away from the records.
First of all, watching Craig's talks on YouTube, that I think that most people are obviously not doing this, because if they were actually listening to what Craig was saying, we'd be building a whole lot of stuff right now that seems to be very, very sort of, very early stage. So what I think is going on is, after all this time, Craig is dumping out information finally, because they patented all this stuff, and finally explaining things to people. And what's going on is, you have people that, basically, people like us that actually listen to what Craig is saying, we can act on this information because he's genuinely explaining things, and he's doing it in this weird sort of high-level way where, like, actually he's still being completely ignored by the entire rest of the cryptocurrency industry. So what I'm doing that I'm gradually realizing, holy shit, I have, like, years on these people because they aren't listening to any of these things, okay? So what I'm going to explain is this cool idea I had that, well, this isn't my idea at all. What it is Craig has been talking about this for freaking ever. And even though I'm working on this and understand all these things, even I didn't understand what he was talking about until finally clicked with me. So I'm going to explain this stuff first, because you can start to understand how we're going to build MetaNet.
Unfortunately, most people in this space seem to be too young to even remember the development of the internet or anything like this. So we're sitting there going, tokens and whatever else, no law. Tell that to MIGO. MIGO were a distributed partnership, effectively. They launched a whole lot of token sales back in 1999. The SEC basically put them over the table and raped them until they squealed. Because they said, we're a partnership. Oh, sorry, we're not a partnership, we're just a distributed group of developers. And the SEC figured out every single one of them that they could reach, and they said, you're liable, you're liable, you're liable, the rest of a partnership, you guys chase them up. We're putting you in jail if you can't get the money out of these guys. Guess what? Every single thing that you're saying about tokens not being covered is utter bullshit. It was all covered with cryptocurrency law, Mondex, CLP, eCash, Mark Twain Bank, yes, the first cryptocurrency bank was launched in the mid-90s. All these things are not new, but you're running around going decentralized. Decentralized is about a distributed system. Peer-to-peer technology means someone can come and go, not that every person on Earth runs it. And the biggest mistake I made is in October 2008, when I was talking to the known, and which I didn't know at the time, child pornographer, James Donald. And he is. He's been put on a whole lot of things, and he runs to different countries now because the media actually exposed him. He is a child pornographer. He was arguing about this whole concept with me, and he tried to tell me that Bitcoin was broken. And I didn't get it at the time, because this guy didn't want Bitcoin. He wanted child porn coin. He wanted, like all the others want, this system that works outside government. Do you know how many nodes you need to freeze to basically force miners to take Ethereum anywhere in the world? Three. You know how many court orders you need to do that? Two. That covers every token ever issued on Ethereum. Full fucking stop.